Rock Eyes would like to welcome George Becker, Jaded Past. Hey, man, what's going on? What's up?
What's up, brother? How you doing?
Hey, man, you had a show tonight, huh?
Yeah, I had a solo show. I do several during the week, acoustic solo. You got to pay the bill somehow, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Do you play all originals, or do you play some covers? Or
I mix it up. A lot of classic rock stripped down. But for the most part, I do a little bit of each, so not too bad.
Good. I know you got a new release coming up, I think April 16th, I believe. And
The tentative date is April 16th.
Right.
If my producer's on right, then we'll get it April 16th.
Cool. Okay, give me some background on the new disc and tell me a little bit about it.
Okay. For the past 9 months, I'm going to say, I've been in the studio with Steve Brown from Trickster, and he's producing my record. Steve and myself are doing most of the tracks, and then we bring in some of our musician friends here and there to fill in the tracks. As you know, when we talked last time, Jaded Past is basically almost like a Nine Inch Nails type of thing, where I kind of do the whole record, and then I put together a live ensemble to go out on tour, you know?
Right.
Which I have a killer lineup for 2016. But we could talk about that in a little bit. As far as the record goes, it's very mature compared to the last debut record that we had. You know, some of the stuff is far more matured. But the same style.
Right.
You know, it's got an 80s feel, but it's a little more rocking, and it's very placed for live performance.
Right.
You know, all the tunes are very written around the live performance.
Right. How many tracks will it be?
Well, there's 8 new ones, and I'm remastering a couple from the original, from the debut record, only because, you know, if we do get picked up, or Steve's shopping it around, so if we do get picked up, I don't want the main songs from the first record to be falling through the cracks, so we're remastering them, just putting them on the bonus at the end of the record.
Right. Now, are you looking for an independent label, or are you looking, what are you looking for?
Well, as you know me, I'm looking for anything. I'm looking for an independent label that can give me distribution.
Right.
Because it's a finished product, so, you know, if they could market it out and get me radio airplay of any sort, right, that'll be great for me, you know, and some tour dates. I really want to latch on to a tour.
Right.
So it's a lot easier when you got a label.
Right. I mean, a lot of bands these days are doing everything in-house and, you know, at their own expense and stuff like that.
Right.
You know, many bands don't even want a label anymore. Do you think there's a need for that?
Well, you know, to record the record, there's not a need for it.
Right.
But I got to tell you, you know, if you really want to get any kind of airplay, or, you know, what the labels do is they match you with other bands on the label to price out a tour.
Right.
You know, it's real hard to get on these tour runs when you're not part of the label.
Right.
So, you know, that's what I'm looking for. I'm really looking for a distribution of some sort.
Right.
And I'm not talking about iTunes, because, you know, anybody can do that.
Right.
But, you know, for the masses, you know, to get it across the country and even overseas.
Right.
I'm really looking to do some stuff overseas.
Wow.
You know?
Yeah. Now you say airplay. Is there radio still around?
Wow. Yeah. I'm damned if I do, damned if I don't, if I can't answer that question the right way.
Right, yeah.
Of course there is. There's a lot of radio stations, man.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's just that it's hard to get on, you know. But if you can get on any kind of satellite radio,
right,
you know, we've gotten airplay with college radio stations and these independent web radio stations.
Right.
Which only goes so far.
Uh-huh.
And there's really no telling what the market is.
Right.
As far as web radios goes, like there's no way to tell who you're reaching.
Right.
You know, and that's the problem I feel.
Right, yeah, definitely, definitely. I hear they're cracking down on internet radio, too, like, you know, people who were doing it out of their home and stuff like that. I hear, you know, I guess the FCC or whatever is starting to crack down on them people, I guess because of royalties, you know?
Well, it is. I think they're trying to, because they can't regulate it.
Right.
So that's what they're trying to do.
Right.
I mean, I really don't know the ins and outs of it. I don't really want to. I got enough on my plate to be dealing with that. So,
wow. Now, tell me about your live band. You were just talking about it. I know you're going out with you're going to go and play some shows with Tracy Guns and stuff like that in April. I was reading and stuff like that. So, tell me what your touring band consists of.
Okay. This time around, I grabbed some old friends. Jack Frost from Seven Witches is playing guitar for me.
Right.
I was playing rhythm guitar in the past, and I decided to step out and be more of a front man.
Right.
So I'm going to lay back on that. My bass player is Mike Lisa from the band Natural Born Losers.
Uh-huh.
He's a New Jersey. I played with him in Hex back in the days.
Wow.
Before Wicked Sin, even. So me and him go back a long way. And Joe Catano is the drummer.
Right.
He's, you know, he's been around. He was in Ritual, and he's been around Jersey for a while. So these guys know the feel. You know, they know what I want. They, you know.
Right.
And we've been rehearsing, and we're ready to go. We got some shows with Faster Pussycat. We got some shows with Tracy Guns. And, you know, we're going to be traveling. So hopefully it'll get around.
Cool, cool. How difficult is it really to make an impact in music anymore?
I don't think it's hard at all.
Yeah?
You just, what I think is, if you want to do it, then you just do it. You know, without expectations. You know, my whole thing is, you've known me for a long time.
Right.
And I treat this the same way I treated it back then when you first met me.
Right.
If you do what you really like to do, it either comes or it doesn't come, you know? I consider myself successful only because I'm making a living playing music. I do have to go. I play a lot of acoustic solo shows, and I do play in a part-time cover band, and Jada Pass goes out, all that stuff like that. But if you wrap it around, I'm still doing what I love to do. And to me, that's, you know, that's making an impact. I mean,
right.
You know, I'm hoping that, you know, people around the area know who I am, and I'll continue to market it that way, you know?
Right, right.
So we'll see what happens with that.
Cool, cool. Now, is there any goal you'd like to reach as, I guess, an independent artist?
Yeah. I would like to tour the United States. I would like to tour Europe and Japan. That's my bucket list. And I've done some of it, and I haven't done some of it. So I would like people to enjoy what I've written. Like I said, you know, the days of being a rock star are few and far in between, so that's not a goal of mine.
Right.
You know, a goal of mine is just reaching people with my music.
Right.
Wow. You know, hoping that it works out.
Cool, cool. Now, you know, when you're recognized and stuff like that, and you have fans and stuff like that, and, you know, you got to give autographs and pictures and stuff, what's that feeling like to you?
For me?
Yes.
Well, I mean, you know, I've gotten it on the local level, maybe even a regional level.
Right.
I haven't gotten to it on a national level just yet. You know, we've built pockets of fans in certain, like in Baltimore and Rhode Island, in Jersey. Not too bad, Pennsylvania. So I think it's great. I think it's the best feeling in the world. Admiration, you know, that's what you strive for.
Right, right.
You know?
Cool, cool. If you could go out with another band besides Trickster, okay?
Wow.
Yeah, besides Trickster. Who would it be?
Oh, A big band or just
any band that you really admire or whatever?
Well, of course, I run Aerosmith, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, if you want to pull it that way, you know, Aerosmith, AC/DC type thing. But if not that, there's bands on a lower scale that I would love to go out with, you know, Bret Michaels.
Right.
You know, anything from the Bon Jovi sector, you know, even if it was just like, you know, on a solo levels.
Right.
I just want to go out and play to as many people as I can. So anything that can bring me that. But it would have to be in my genre, you know.
Right.
I play radio rock.
Right.
So putting me with heavy metal bands at places like Starland isn't going to work for me.
Right, yeah.
You know, I mean, I would love to play with, you know, Buck Cherry and stuff like that, but I'm not sure that we even fit.
Right.
So.
Right, right. As a lead vocalist, is there any kind of ritual or warm-up you have to do before you go on stage?
Me?
Yeah.
No, not really.
Yeah. No.
I like to be alone for a little while, but I don't really do all of that. You know, wouldn't be too rock star if, you know, you're telling everybody you're drinking hot tea back there and stuff like that. But, you know, we are older and, you know, we're not 22 anymore, so things have changed since the first time you've met me. So
right.
Then we'll just leave it at that.
Right, right.
I'll keep my rituals to myself.
Yeah, yeah. But everything comes full fold. Like back then when Wicked Sin and stuff, it was vinyl. Then it became CD, and now it's going back to vinyl again. What's your feeling about vinyl making a resurgence?
Well, I'll tell you, when we started this record, we were I actually that. And we might do a grouping of vinyl,
right?
If we can, the cost is still way up there. Like, you know, when you're going to mass produce
right.
the CDs, and you say, oh, well, maybe we'll do a batch of actual LPs, you know,
right?
It the cost is immense, so we got to see what happens with that.
Right.
I wouldn't mind having one for myself, but
right,
we'll see where that goes.
Right. Is there anything else coming up in this year besides the CD and some shows? Is there anything else you're working on or anything else you want to talk about?
Yeah. I'm going to say, you know, whoever's listening, if they enjoy anything that I do, I do a lot of acoustic solo stuff, and I'm really trying to build my own brand along with Jaded Past.
Right.
Jaded Past is a project that I started in 2012, which I love and I continue to love. I write most of the songs for Jaded Past, but I also am writing some solo stuff that it doesn't really fit that. And I'll be putting that out on iTunes during this year. A lot of ballads. I have stuff with a country feel to it. I'm actually going down to Nashville in April. I'm going to play a couple of solo gigs down in Nashville at a couple of bars, and I'm going to feel out that. So yeah, that's happening a lot. I'm trying to build my own brand within Jaded Past.
Right.
So that's another thing I'm doing.
Cool. Is there any merchandise or anything else people could pick up from you now?
We are currently doing all the merch for the 2016 shows. They're going to be integrated with the CD, so everything will be available in a couple of weeks.
Right.
Right after April 16th on the website, jadedpast.com.
Cool. And they also could track you down through Facebook?
Everything, yeah. Facebook, Twitter. The website, jadedpast.com, has my solo dates on it. It has everything on it. Videos. We plan on doing a couple of videos for this record, too.
Right.
Not as many as the last one. I'm going to pick and choose what we're actually going to do for this one. I put out 4 videos for the last record, and I think maybe there might be 2.
Right.
3. I say that now, but I get the bug, and I start to see them, and I, you know.
Right. Yeah.
You
cool.
Just,
cool. Very, so. Very cool. Well, George Becker, Jaded Past. Solo artist, everything, the new disc, Believe, coming out in April. Congratulations on that. And, you know, I wish you the best. I know you a very long time, you're a good friend. And, you know, I hope everything goes well for you. Would you like to say anything to the fans before we end?
I would just like to say, if you want to come out and see a great show, I have a new killer lineup. I still love my old guys. We're still tight and friends, so, you know, there's nothing to do with that. It's just that, you know, with scheduling, I had to put together a new lineup. It's killer. It's shows that are coming up. We're going to be in Rhode Island in April. We're also going to be in Jersey at Dingbats on April 30th with Fast Tracy Gunn. Sorry. Rhode Island's going to be the fastest place to get. All the dates that we're doing, everything Jaded Pass will be on jadedpass.com.
Cool.
You can look up anything on jadedpass.com.
Great, great. Thanks a lot, George.
All right, man. Thanks a lot.
No problem. Bye-bye.